prayer right now. As a child of God, can you close out everything else? Everything else aside, and pray, really pray, really ask God to come in, work, help, do. Well, I believe we can. I'm going to go to prayer right now. And so if you'll join your pastor, rise up together. We're going to pray in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we come to you tonight and we offer prayer in the name of Jesus for every need, for every condition, for every single thing that might stand before you in this great universe. Lord, we offer prayer. We offer, Lord, the name of the individuals in prayer. You heard those names called individually tonight over this area. People in need of healing, in need of help. Tumors in their body, missing for 30 days. Oh God, all kind of afflictions, all kinds of needs in homes, and a lung infection, and surgery pending, and oh God, a fall and a bruise. Oh God, you heard the names. Not only these in this local assembly, but all the moaning and the groaning of humanity tonight, all over the universe, you hear and you see and you know, and Lord, you're aware of the conditions, and you're aware of the need, and Father, we're just praying that the universe tonight will feel the effects of the band of people praying. Wherever your people are praying, wherever there's a need, wherever there's a calling unto the Lord, we pray tonight that assemblies will be blessed and churches will be blessed and congregational gatherings will be blessed. And we pray for individuals that are praying and cell meetings at home individually. And we pray for ministers tonight. And we pray for the church with its needs so magnified and so outstanding. Oh God, that they would be caught up in the power and prayer of the deliverance of the Holy Ghost coming back into the church and through the church. And we would manifest the love of God, manifest the healing, manifest the praise, manifest the joy that is in the church tonight. Praise the name of the Lord. And this place would be filled with a message of truth and the Spirit of God, and that individually everyone would be strengthened in the Holy Ghost, and we would leave here new in our spirit, renewed in our hearts, and we know that you healed and you blessed and you delivered us in the name of Jesus tonight. In the name of Jesus tonight. In the name of Jesus tonight. In the holy, powerful name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord, that sickness would flee our houses and flee our land, flee our people, Lord, in Jesus' name. And you would keep us in a troubled nation. And we pray for this nation, America. And we pray for its leadership. And we pray for the people of this great country and of the world. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise God. We're going going to get our offering ready tonight, and let's give a bountiful offering on this Saturday night. Always Wednesday night is a more slender offering from the church because people have not received their paychecks and they haven't gotten access to their offering, but tonight, Saturday night, usually the burden night that we carry the offering, so everyone just absolutely get your offering and get your bountiful offering, and may the Lord bless you as you give a special offering. God always blesses me when I give, and I give abundantly. I don't ever withhold from God's word. I never come to service without an offering in my pocket. I never, never sit in a chair while an offering is being given, because I want people to realize this is a blessing of the Lord. This is a bountiful chance for me to be blessed to the Lord. So, do we have a song? Do we have a praise? Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord.
As the world looks upon me, as I struggle alone, they say I have nothing.
Thank you. doctor, she looked at me and said, well, there's nothing wrong. It's just on your head, or you're just, you're nervous about something. And she gave me a pill. I said, I didn't take the pill, but I'm like, it's not that. And I felt in my gut to get a second opinion. And my new doctor took one look at me. He says, that's melanoma on your nose. And he took a quick looking at my back. He says, I see signs of skin cancer. So I got an emergency appointment the next day. And the doctor took one look at me and said, you know what? He goes, whatever you felt is melanoma was on my nose. And they were circling. I had cancer, five spots on my back. And I knew, I was like, you know, when you listen to the inside, and I feel like I was praying, it was like, you know, skin cancer comes in different degrees. And I said, melanoma, I was like, oh my gosh, you know, what I've been through enough, what do I have to go through more? And they did cut out the spots on my back and my nose. And I was like, I knew something was right, because as soon as they cut everything out, the itching stopped. It's like, you know, I was like, oh my gosh, you know, and that's such a relief there. And then I waited for a whole week, and then while the stitches were coming back and all that, and I went this past Wednesday and Thursday, and he said, we got the one on your nose. It was the beginning melanoma, but we got it all. We cut it out. And he goes, and the five spots on your back. He goes, it's very, very, very beginning cancer. And he goes, you don't have to come see me again. So the Lord protected me. And I just saw it have relief. And when you're laying down and being silent and have to be still, you know, things happen. It's like, you know, this is for a reason. You know, it's to where God can talk to you. And I just want to thank God, and that's a praise report, because I don't have cancer. He said, I'll see you in 6 months. Lord. Give a praise report and thank God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Glory to the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise. Wouldn't you like to hear of an hour of that in the church?
Yeah.
Healing from God.
Yes.
Would that be wonderful? Just to hear.
Praise God, yes.
Hear it more and more. And thank God, Sister Michelle, that you don't have cancer.
No.
That's the bottom line. You don't have cancer.
Yes.
So praise God for that.
Yes.
I want to deal, if I can, for a few minutes on my feet tonight. But I don't want this to be an ordinary Saturday night where Brother Marlowe has rhetoric and you dutifully sit and listen. I want you to be involved in the message that I'm giving. And if you're not, it could be my problem or it could be your problem. But I'm going to do my best when I stand on my feet that I connect with those around me. And I know some of you, my back is to you. And some of you, you're looking at me from the side. And some of you are way over here, and some back here. I always prayed the Lord would give me a church very compact. And because distance between the saints makes it many times the praise, the joy, and the enthusiasm less than when the saints are more compact together. But I've really been praying, oh God, let me or someone, if you have another messenger to call here to this pulpit, that would arouse this church, arouse the people of God, then call them. Or if they're around me, let me give way to them. And let them be able to arouse the church. And would you put that piano lid down? It was Brother Tansy there, looking over the piano there, through the piano. I want them to be able to hear me and see me. I want to arouse the church. In my preaching, I don't want to be just a man standing here taking your time. Because it's very important right now that the church is able to match or be in the perfect will of God to deal with the perfect age of destruction. that we're in right now. We're in the end time of a world. You're getting ready to see a world crash before your eyes. You're getting ready to see the most tremendous upheaval in a nation since we've been a nation. You're getting ready to see Europe troubled like they've never been, Asia, because the world is in chaos and is fulfilling prophecy of God's word. I want to give you some scriptures, and go with me in these. In Isaiah, the 24th chapter, we have this picture of the present age. And I'm not morbid tonight now. And when I finish this message, I want you to be able to shout and praise God. I don't want you with your heads down. I don't want gloomy elders around me or gloomy people. And I want people to be the mirror that reflects what God is doing right now, because the church must arouse itself to where it can deal with the hordes and hordes of people that are not in mega churches. They're not in churches. Not in the mega church. They're not in the charismatic church. They're not in the Protestant churches. Not in Catholicism. There are millions and millions of people that are out of all churches. They don't go to any.
That's it.
They don't have confidence in any.
That's it.
Including this one. They don't have confidence in any of the Pentecostal churches. Millions of them across America. And that's the people that God wants to harvest right now. See, I want to be careful what I say on this camera here, on this internet, because this can be wisdom or not wisdom, and what we say that goes out, because everything we say goes across the world, and people are listening. But I want to be sure that I say there's a condition in the United States now that is getting my attention as a prophet, as a leader of the church. And I'm aroused by it, and I go to God's word when I'm aroused. I go to the scriptures, because that's where I find my answers. What's happening? What's causing the turmoil? What's causing the anarchy right now? What's causing Americans to getting ready to fight Americans? What's causing this nation to be in the upheaval that it's in? Well, one answer is that there are individuals that are touching the people that are disgusted with law.
Yes.
They're disgusted with religion.
Yes.
They're disgusted with all of the rules and ethics of society. And they are ready for any change, whether it's right or wrong, whether it's a good leader or a bad leader, whether it's somebody that is going to lead them down the right path or someone's going to lead them down their own path. They're just ready for change. And these millions of people now are fermenting in this country and in Europe and in the Middle East. And they're going to have change. Whether that change is violent or nonviolent, or whether it is going to be right or whether it's going to be wrong. Now, the church can't go on placidly feeding ourselves, taking care of ourselves. We can't go on being content to occupy chairs and positions and just have rhetoric among us that preachers should be ashamed of themselves right now. Men of God that are called of God, if they're not fastening themselves to the horns of the altar,
yes,
and praying for God to give them messages that will first arouse the church that's following them. And then the church opened the door to this harvest field of millions of people that are outside of religion, settled in religion. You're not going to do much with people that are converted into religion. People that are church members and established in churches, they're satisfied for their routine, their doctrine, their teachings. What they believe, what they don't believe, anything new that God has to give in this hour, anything that matches the last days, anything that's a cure and a remedy for the end time sins of men, they're not going to pay much attention because they're settled in what they believe. They're settled in what has been taught them. They're settled in the conviction that they're all right. After all, they're a church member. After all, they go to some religious group somewhere. But there's millions of people that don't go anywhere. And they're the lonely, and they're the lost, and they're the afraid. Now, if we go on with our routine just like others do, and somewhere there's not a breaking out of the Pentecostal church, the Spirit-filled church, the body of Christ, the people of God that are called of God to study the depth of scriptures and get revelation from God, and with a fresh approach and a fresh message, and then signs and wonders following them, and them being an example so they can show people that are lost, that don't know what to believe, and they're hunting something because they're sick and tired of being sick and tired. And they're sick and tired of the establishment.
Yes.
They don't want the establishment. Whether it's politics, whether it's the church, whether it's business,
yes,
whether it's corporations, they want something that will heal their sin-sick soul and bring them out of the gutter that they're in. They want something besides stale religion. They want something that is dynamic, that they feel is sent from God, that they can't deny is from God. And somewhere, the New Testament church, if it's going to appear in our day, it